The Commonwealth of Virginia melting into a state of chaos with scandals growing against all three top elected officials, all of them Democrats. Today, the woman accusing Lieutenant Governor Justin Fairfax of sexual assault came forward and under her own name provided very specific details of her claim against him. Also today, a stunning admission from Virginia's Attorney General Mark Herring, who revealed he once wore blackface in college. He said he was dressed as a rapper in the style of the legendary Curtis Blow. This comes after Herring had joined the chorus of Democrats who called on Virginia's governor, Ralph Northam, to resign after Northam, too, confessed to having put on blackface. Herring called that photograph on Northam's medical school yearbook page indefensible, profoundly offensive, shocking, and deeply disappointing. Let's go to CNN's Ryan Nobles. He's in Richmond, the capital of the Commonwealth. Ryan, how could Herring have said all that about Northam and that horrific blackface image if he had his own scandal?
Yeah, that is a great question, Jake, and it certainly appears to be a level of hypocrisy from the Attorney General, and we simply are not getting the answer to that question because he's not answering questions on this topic. He has been holed up in his office all day, his staff not responding to our repeated inquiries. All we have to work off of is this lengthy statement, which appeared to come ahead of the effort by many reporters, including us here at CNN, to find this photograph of the Attorney General dressed in blackface. And this is what he said in the statement. He said, quote, "I had a callous and inexcusable lack of awareness and insensitivity to the pain my behavior could inflict on others. It was really a minimization of both people of color and a minimization of a horrific history I knew well even then." And to put this into context, Herring said this happened when he was in college at the University of Virginia when he was 19 years old. This happened in 1980. He said it was part of a costume party that he was taking part in. And he goes to great pains in this statement, Jake, to make it seem as though this would not be what people would traditionally describe as blackface. He talks about putting on brown makeup. But I think most objective observers would recognize that this is also a problem for the Attorney General. And it just adads to the list of scandals gripping Capitol Square here.
Yeah, and let's turn to another one. Lieutenant Governor Justin Fairfax put out a statement today saying that no one should denigrate his accuser, Dr. Vanessa Tyson, but he called her allegations of sexual assault not true.
Yeah, that's right, Jake. And what's interesting about this was that the lieutenant governor got out ahead of Vanessa Tyson telling her story. And he went to great pains to say things like this was a consensual relationship, that he didn't view this as a problem, that he'd never heard anything from her for many years after it took place. And basically everything that he has said over the past couple of days has been refuted by Ms. Tyson in a very lengthy statement that goes into great detail of her view as to what happened on that night back in 2004. She writes, quote, "What began as a consensual kissing quickly turned into a sexual assault. Mr. Fairfax put his hand behind my neck and forcefully pushed my head toward his crotch." And the lieutenant governor taking an opposite approach to Governor Ralph Northam in the controversy that he's embroiled in. He tried to get out ahead of it. And he's also gone on a blistering attack of his accuser. We're told in private meetings he's gone into expletive-laden rants attacking her and those supporting her. He firmly believes that he is not wrong in this case, and he has vowed to fight these accusations to the bitter end. Jake.
All right, Ryan Nobles in Richmond, Virginia. Thank you so much. Let's talk about this with our reporters. Ryan, stick around. Abby, let me start with you, the obvious here. This is a horrible, horrible week for Democrats in Virginia.
It's almost unimaginable that it could have snowballed in this way. You now have three top officials in that state embroiled in really serious controversies. And the problem politically for Democrats is that the two issues at hand here, racism and the Me Too movement, are two issues that the Democratic Party has helped to elevate to the national stage. They are central to what they've been doing over the last several years, both in response to Donald Trump and all of the controversies around him, but also just trying to make this a part of how they respond to their own base. And so for them to have a governor and an attorney general who have admitted to basically using blackface in the 1980s, which was not a time when blackface was acceptable, that time has long been passed. And also their lieutenant governor, who is also embroiled in a controversy that is really kind of at the crux of the Me Too movement, it's a real problem for them. And it's not clear to me how they resolve this in a satisfactory way.
I wonder if in some weird and bizarre way, the fact that all three of them are involved in scandals almost helps them keep office, because why would this guy resign and not that guy? Why would that guy resign and not that guy? And the one who ultimately would take their job if all three had to resign is the Republican Speaker of the state legislature.
And I think that may inoculate Democrats from cooling their jets a little bit here and calling for more resignations. The reality here is we have not seen anything like this at all. I cannot think of any historical comparison, at least in modern time, to there being, you know, this trifecta of issues here that are such part of our current moment and conversation. That's what makes this so extraordinary. There is a racial discussion happening in America. Virginia has been front and center of so much of this with Charlottesville, now the Me Too movement. But Democrats, you know, they've been a little bit hypocritical along the way here as well. And now we will see how forthcoming they are of calling for all of them to be out because they don't want a Republican to be leading what is a swing state here. So it's very odd. But since the Virginia governorship is a one-term position, that is also changing the sort of discussion here. He may just hold on, but boy, that grinds everything to a halt and has national implications as well.
And Ryan, Herring was quick a few days ago to call on Virginia Governor Northam to resign because of his blackface incident. What's the response in Virginia now to Herring admitting that he put on blackface to dress up in college?
Well, it's pretty remarkable, Jake, because as you mentioned, it wasn't just Herring, but almost all corners of Virginia government were quick to call on the governor to resign. Today, we got a very muted response from lawmakers. No one even wanted to talk about it, much less call on either of these two other lawmakers to step down. And it seems to be a level of hypocrisy at that point. Particularly one of the groups that we're very keyed in on is the Legislative Black Caucus, which is a very influential group of Virginia legislators. They were the first to call on the governor to resign. That started the snowball effect. At this point, they've only said that they're looking into Lieutenant Governor Fairfax's accusations. They've said nothing about the attorney general, even though they held an emergency meeting with him earlier today to discuss these issues. I think you're right about your assessment here. The fact that we had three scandals by three prominent leaders in such a short window of time increases the likelihood that all three of these men may just stay in power and play out the string until their terms are over.